Welcome you all to today's English class. Today we will discuss sixth lesson of the book First Flight, that is 100 Dresses 2. And in this lesson, we will discuss the rest part of the story. But before we start, let's summarize what we have already read. In lesson 6, in the beginning what we have read, actually it's a connected lesson, lesson 5 and 6, these two are connected lesson. It is the story of Vanda Petnoski, Peggy and Maddie, those who are classmates, and Vanda Petnoski is a Polish girl, and she is bullied by other classmates because she is a Polish girl. She comes from Bogen Heights, it's a poor place, and now she wears only a single dress. And that is why Peggy, she asks her so many times, she asks her the same question, she teases her and she says that how many dresses do you have? And she always answers, but she says that she has 100 dresses. So this lesson, this story actually reveals that how Peggy and Maddie, they treat her, how the other classmates treat her. She is bullied by other students about her name also, and ultimately she leaves her school. And when she leaves her school, before that she had already submitted her designs, drawings, and they were 100 dresses, well designed, beautiful dresses, and she got first prize, but she was not there to receive that prize. And Maddie, she is also a girl who doesn't want to torture her, who doesn't want to say anything to her, but what she is fearful of, that she would be, now she would be the next target for Peggy. If she stops her, she would be the next target. That's why she just accompanies her and let her do what she is doing. Then in the sixth lesson what we have read, that now Peggy is not there, Vanda Petnoski is not there, she has gone, and now what they are feeling, what they are thinking, that they should go to that place, they should amend for their things what they have done with her, and they should stop her from going there, going to any place, because now they came to know that how she was, what a brilliant child she was, huh? And now they went to find at her place, but she was not there. Now let's see next what happens in the story. On Saturday, Maddie spent the afternoon with Peggy. They were writing a letter to Vanda Petnoski. Actually now they went to that place, but they could not find her, she had already gone. So now they decided, it was Saturday, and they decided to write a letter to Vanda. It was just a friendly letter telling about the contest and telling Vanda she had won. And they just had written a friendly letter telling her about the drawing contest and as she has won. They told her how pretty her drawings were. Now what they wanted to tell her, that her drawings were really very beautiful. And they asked her if she liked where she was living and if she liked her new teacher. Now they were also asking about her new teacher and the place where they live, where she is living now. They had meant to say they were sorry. Now they were just feeling sorry for their mistakes. But it ended up with their just writing a friendly letter, the kind they would have written to any good friend. Or they wrote a letter which they would have written to any good friend, the kind, and they signed it with lots of love. They mailed the letter to Bogen's Heights, writing please forward on the envelope. And now they wrote the letter where she already lived, and they wrote that it should be forwarded to where she is living now. Days passed and there was no answer, but the letter did not come back. So maybe Vanda had received it. So days passed, they did not receive any letter, and what they were thinking, whether Vanda had received the letter or not. Perhaps she was so hurt and angry, she was not going to answer. You could not blame her. Now perhaps she was so hurt and angry that she was not going to answer. Maybe she must be angry with them, and that's why she was not answering. Weeks went by and still Vanda did not answer. Again weeks went by, so many weeks passed, but they did not receive any letter. Peggy had begun to forget the whole business, because Peggy was not much concerned about vendor. And but she thought that she had not committed any mistake. She had just asked her question because she always told lies. So she just wanted to know the reality. And that's why she had no guilt. And Maddie put herself to sleep at night, making speeches about Venda, defending her from great crowds of girls who were trying to tease with her. And Maddie put herself to sleep at night. Now Maddie was in stress. Why she was, what she was thinking, that making speeches about Venda, that why they should tell about Venda, defending her from the crowd. She always had that kind of feeling. How many dresses have we got? And before Venda could press her lips together in a tight line, the way she did before answering, Maddie would cry out, "Stop!" Then everybody would feel ashamed the way she used to feel. Now, before Venda could press her lips, now she could she was not able to answer the question again and again, Venda. And whenever she answered that question, 100 dresses, the way she did before answering, Maddie would cry out, "Stop!" Now what she was thinking, I should have stopped everyone from making abuse and making her, bully her, okay? And she should have stopped them. Now it was Christmas time and there was snow on the ground. Christmas bells and a small tree decorated the classroom. So it was Christmas time. On the last day of school before the holidays, the teacher showed the class a letter she had received that morning. And that day, the teacher had received a letter and she showed that letter to the class. You remember Venda Petnoski, the gifted little artist who won the drawing contest? Now teacher asks, you know Venda Petnoski? She is the one who had won drawing contest. Well, she has written me and I am glad to know where she lives, because now I can send her medal. I want to read her letter to you. Now she had sent me the letter and she had sent her address also. Now I will be able to send her medal and certificates, all that. The class sat up with a sudden interest and listened intently. Now class, listen to the letter. What was written there? "How are you in room 13? Please tell the girls they can keep those 100 dresses, because in my new house I have 100 new ones all lined up in my closet." Now she had written that how these all my classmates are, and she wanted all those 100 dresses to be kept by other girls, because she had again prepared those 100 dresses all lined up. "I would like that Peggy to have the drawing of the green dress with red trimmings, and her friend Maddie to have the blue one. And specially she mentioned the names of Peggy and Maddie to keep those dresses. For Christmas, I miss that school and my new teacher does not equalize with you. And I miss you, ma'am, because my new teacher is not equal to you. Many Christmas to you and everybody." So this was written by Venda Petnoski. On the way home from school, Maddie and Peggy held their drawings very carefully. Now they took drawings from blue and green dresses. All the houses had wreaths and holly in the windows. Outside the grocery store, hundreds of Christmas trees were stacked, and in the window, candy, peppermint sticks and copenhagens of shiny transparent paper were strung. All these decorated, every place was decorated, because it was the Christmas Eve and all were all shining, decorating. Copenhagens is decorative containers. Okay, so boys and Peggy, this shows she really likes us. Now, what she said, what Peggy says, that now she likes us so much. It shows she got our letter, and this is our way of saying that everything is alright. And now the way she has written the letter, it shows that everything is well and she was not having any grudges against us. And that is that. "I hope so," said Maddie sadly. She felt sad because she knew she would never see the little tight-lipped Polish girl again and couldn't even really make things right between them. Now, but Maddie was sorry for the things, because now she would not be able to meet Venda Petnoski and she could not make amends for the mistakes she had done. She went home and she pinned her drawing over a torn place in the pink flowered wallpaper in the bedroom. Now, Maddie, she put her drawing in the pink flowered wallpaper in the bedroom. The shabby room came alive from the brilliancy of the color. Now, her room was quite shabby. She was also a poor girl, but that became alive because of that drawing. Maddie sat down on her bed and looked at the drawing. Now, Maddie just looked at the dress. She had stood by and said nothing, but Venda had been nice to her anyway. And what she was thinking, that she never favored Venda, but Benda was always nice to her. Tears blurred her eyes and she gazed for a long time at the picture. Now she started weeping and she just looked at the picture again and again. Then hastily she rubbed her eyes and studied it intently. Then she studied the picture intently with great care. The colors in the dress were so vivid that she had scarcely noticed the face and head of the drawing. Now the colors in the dress were so vivid, so colorful that she could not notice the head of that. But it looked like her. But that head was just like Maddie. It really looked like her own mouth. Why it was really looked like her own self? Benda had really drawn this for her. Excitedly she ran out to Peggy's. Now she just went to Peggy's place to let her know that she had drawn this drawing only for us because that resembled my face. Peg, she said, let me see your picture. What is the matter? Asked Betty. As they clattered up to her room where Benda's drawing were lying face down on the bed. Now Peggy was not, she did not bother about that drawing and she kept it on the bed. But Maddie raised that picture. Look, she drew you. That's you, she exclaimed, and the head and the face of the picture did look like Peggy. And now what she's told that this picture really resembles you. What did I say? Said Peggy. She must have really liked us anyway. Now, said Peggy, I was telling that she liked us so much. Yes, she must have. Agreed Maddie, and she blinked away the tears that came every time she thought of Benda standing alone in that sunny spot in the schoolyard, looking stoutly over at the group of laughing girls after she had walked off, after she had said, sure, 100 of them were lined up. So now she blinked away the tears that came every time she thought of Benda. Now when she thought of Benda, every time she started weeping, and she just looked at these laughing girls after she had walked off, and she always said, sure, 100 dresses all lined up. So this is what the story is. Actually, this was the story of the writer herself. She was actually had a real life experience as Maddie, and she was not so bold to resist all the things that were done to Benda McCloskey, and that's why now she had written that letter to make a lesson, to teach a lesson to the students that they should not support such students who bully others, who tease others, and they should support the one not on the basis of their physical features or their family background, but they should consider for their real talent. So this is what the story is, and with that, we have completed this lesson. Thank you.